Everyone is in their seats here at the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles as the Los Angeles Lakers look to grab a win on the home floor. Well, it was the Indiana Pacers in their last game, a loss to Sacramento. That one was real close, too. They lost by just 2 points.
Well, they heaved up a lot of ill-advised three-pointers in that loss. Guys, they were way too trigger-happy from downtown.
Yeah, and that's not the area on the court where you want to be forcing shots from. Heck, you were a great three-point shooter, and you know that, Steve.
Yeah, I mean, it comes and goes, but you can't just rely on that when things aren't going your way.
Here's the starting group for the Indiana Pacers. Scola plays the four with Hibbert at the five. Rodney Stuckey out there with George Hill, and it's George in at the three. Now here's Hill, the fast break opportunity. And Rodney Stuckey the bucket on the assist by George.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spots. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
Here's Bryant. Here's Randall. Nice work on the boards. He's paying off with the basket.
Boy, he crashed the boards with purpose right there. Well-deserved second chance points for him.
Well, Doris, an interesting game. Moments ago, you had a chance to talk with head coach Frank Vogel. What do you have to say?
We discussed their defensive strategy going up against Kobe Bryant. He said, well, he probably has the best footwork of any player in the game. You can't give him any room in his jump shot, but when he's got all those fakes, it's so tough. Guys, he said he knows Kobe is going to get his points. They just want to try to limit his efficiency out there. Guess we'll see how they do.
Thanks, Doris. Chandler against Hill. Kicks it to Scola. Hill left side. Stuckey against Hill. Five on the clock. And George kicks to Hill. The shot's good on the assist by George. Hill's got his first 2 points.
Talk about a great start. 3 of 3 from the field to get the game going. They're cooking with gas, folks.
Here's Kobe. Got it. Good job in the low post.
You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days, that little finger roll.
Looking at Los Angeles, they took the win in their last game against the Magic.
Yeah, and in the end, it wasn't even close. I mean, they had points coming from all over the floor.
Boy, they were locked in and ready to roll, and offensively, they just had a rhythm that was impressive.
Now here's Kobe. He's coming off a 25-point game against Orlando. There's a good screen. G kicks to Randall. It's taken away by Stuckey. Poked loose. And the foul called on.
Put it behind you now. Get ready to go.
Second foul.
23 seconds left here in the first quarter. Outside Hill. Pass to Mahimi. Great D that time from Davis. Here's G. Got it off in time, but it's no good. And so the first quarter. Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. And what stands out to you from the Lakers in this one?
Big boost from their bench there, guys, in that first quarter. They did a nice job coming in and really giving this team a lift.
Yeah, it's a nice attribute to have. Firepower coming off the pine early. That's good stuff.
And in some off-the-court news, he's finishing up details for his own signature shoe, from what I hear. It's been quite the journey for him, and wow, what a great moment that must have been.
Everything that he's gone through to get where he is today, it really is just a culmination of a lot of hard work. This is a bonus. He's now officially made it as an NBA star.
G in at point guard. Gerald Green out there with Caron Butler. Then there's Davis, and it's Young in at the two guard. That's the group for the Lakers to start the second quarter. The feed now to Nova. Hill kicks to Miles. Indiana moving it around. There's the dish to Mahimi, and that's out of bounds. Indiana will retain possession. Now a look at the hottest teams in the league. These squads have knocked down everything in the last 10 games. The Lakers number one.
It's due to better shot selection lately, Kevin. They're taking their time to make sure the shots they take go in. Really good self-discipline there.
Just four to shoot. No good from Clark.
Very porous defense down there by the hoop. He probably should make that one.
And it's Young finishing it off.
Phenomenal alley-oop slam right there, guys.
They're taking advantage, Clark, of a team that looks lost out there.
Yeah, this is threatening to get kind of ugly out here.
Here's Hill following the bucket by the Lakers. Mahimi's shot is good.
Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
Lakers leading by 13. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Here's G. 26 points for him last game against Orlando.
And defensively, he was all over the court, forcing turnovers, putting a ton of pressure on the ball.
And the foul called on G. That's his third foul of the game.
Well, he's boxed out, and when that happens, you know, at some point you have to just turn and get back defensively. That time he went right over the top.
Yeah, but you go straight on the top of another player's back, that's going to be a foul call every time.
Hill, he's checked in for Los Angeles. Luis Scola, he's checked in for the Pacers. Paul George comes in for Ian Clark. Here's the three, and that's collected by Hill.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior, no question. And that's, I think, the main reason they have this lead. They had a defender draped all over. Not really the best shot there.
Well, not the shot you hope for when it's well contested like that.
Here is Mahimi. We saw him with 10 points last game. Hill dishes to George. Fires from the wing. And he overshot that one, missing.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Here's G, right now averaging 25 points a game. Nick Young on the wing, off the pick. And that one's good. Young's got four this quarter.
Great teamwork out there, really helping each other out.
They're playing as one. I mean, they're like a symphony. Everybody in harmony and in rhythm. Five straight baskets now have resulted because of assists.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Randall's checked in for Davis. Chandler comes in for Green. And it's Bryant in for Young. Indiana also making some changes. Roy Hibbert's checked in for Mahimi. Rodney Stuckey subbed in for C.J. Miles. And so it's the Lakers with it. Following the shot by Roy Hibbert. Good! And the Lakers lead by 17.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
Yeah, I think that's what's keyed this run, Clark, because they're keeping the ball moving. Defense hasn't been able to set up.
Now, here is Hill. He's coming off a 16-point game against Sacramento.
Well, he was aggressive at both ends of the floor. He had three steals in that game, remember?
Yes. And then Hibbert with the dunk.
We knew what was going to happen with that one when he got his hands on it.
Yeah, you know, if the ball comes to him off the offensive boards, Clark, it's going to go back down hard.
It's amazing how many points he salvages for his team.
And Doris Burke has a report for us from the sideline.
Well, gee, in the last matchup against the Magic, boy, was he tremendous. He dropped in 26 points and seemed to be seeing the action in slow motion, piling up a huge amount of assists. Numbers like that are rare to see by any player in a game he'll always remember.
Great, Doris. Thanks. Any chance we see him top that performance, Clark, here tonight?
I'd say no chance, Clark. That's not a knock against him. It's just that he was so good that night, I don't think he can possibly do it two games in a row.
He was Kelloggian. Is that a word? We can use that word.
It is. It is now.
Oh, look at Steve. He didn't like that, though. Look at him.
Let's just say he was really good.
So it's the Pacers now after the basket by Los Angeles. Los Angeles leading by 13. Left side, Kobe. Randall with a screen for Bryant. And it's Roy Hibbert with the rebound.
Really good offensive execution. Nice pick. Just couldn't get the...
Oh, get it! Oh, watch out now. A signature slam right there from the big fella. How many of those have we seen before?
G kicks to Hill. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two. Hill's got 4 points now in the quarter. Pacers trail by 13. Hill passes to Hibbert. Outside Hill. Another shot, and there's the nice layup by Hibbert. Hibbert's got 8 points.
It was a slow start for him, but he started to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
G dishes to Bryant. Here's G. He's guarded by Hill. Fires from 14. And Bryant the bucket on the assist by G. G's got assist number 5 here tonight. Hill drives in. Here's Hibbert. Hill gets the rebound. Hill's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Here's G. He's guarded by Stuckey. G powered down with both hands. The defense looking a little bit dazed now. A ferocious throw down there.
Not bad for a player of his size.
Not bad at all. How about that spring coming out of those legs?
Here's George following the bucket by the Lakers. And it's good. He planted his feet on the pick and shielded the defender off.
That was Roy Hibbert getting in the way of the defense there.
Here's G. To the middle. Here's Randle. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Randle's got his second bucket tonight.
They have repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys. And it's paid dividends.
Yeah, it sure has, Clark. I mean, with as many points as they've gotten in the paint, they really haven't had to do much on the perimeter.
Here's G. Knocked loose. An easy 2 points on the layup. G's got 6 here in this quarter. And let's get your guys' take now on the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
Boy, their frenetic defense has really been impressive, putting a lot of pressure on ball handlers and turning them over.
Something else they've done right so far from the get-go tonight is run. I mean, so much of their offense has come off the fast break.
Yeah, the defender draped all over.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
This is his first trip to the line tonight. That free throw good from G. Some changes for the Lakers. Butler comes in for Jordan Hill. And it's Jeremy Lin in for Kobe. Then for the Pacers, Novak's checked in. And Ian Clark subbed in for George Hill. Clark kicks to George. Clark the pass to George. Here's Hibbert. A terrific shot on the turnaround. Hibbert's got 10 points in the game.
And his shots are dropping right now. This quarter has been very kind to him.
Here's G. He's guarded by Stuckey. G dishes to Lin. Just 5 to shoot. G passes to Randle. Misses from short range.
I thought he rushed it a little bit, guys, because he had a clean look, just lost his focus.
And here's George for 3. Phenomenal yes, buzzer sir. Beater!
You gotta love seeing nothing but zeros on the clock when that ball tickles the twine.
Oh, man, a clutch shot.
And so we wrap up the first half. Lakers lead by 13. We'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
Okay, guys, solid play so far. I like what I'm seeing. But just a few things to talk about before the second half. These are the types of halves where we are helping ourselves out by making clean passes. They haven't caused us too many problems in the passing lanes to this point, but we still have a half of basketball to play. I did like the scoring punch we got off the bench. That heated things up for us when we had to have a little something extra. Also, we can sacrifice some manpower on the defensive glass in this half in order to have opportunities to get the break started with bodies already headed up the court. And that's all I wanted to go over with you. Let's go play a good half of basketball.
Keep it simple every time.
Okay. We're just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game.
Well, how about Paul George in this one? He has 11 points and he's put 1 3-pointer on the board.
Yeah, he's got to take his time behind the arc.
Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. On the court right now for the Pacers, George and Skoa, they're the forwards. George Hill out there with Rodney Stuckey. and it's Hibbert in at the center, filling out the middle. Here is Stuckey, following the basket by Kobe Bryant. George double-teamed. Back to Stuckey. He dishes it to Hibbert. Indiana moving the ball around. Hill has the open look. They get it back. And the basket by Scola.
Boy, where was the box out? Too easy on that second chance opportunity.
Yeah, no box out is what happened there. Those kind of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
Here's G. 7 points in the game. Let's take this moment to bring you a leaderboard featuring a very well-rounded group, the top rebounding small forwards in the NBA the last 10 games. Second is Paul George.
And maybe they're not the biggest or strongest players in the front court, but that hasn't limited their ability to get in there, mix it up, and come up with a lot of rebounds night in and night out.
Yeah, you mentioned their lack of size and strength compared to the post players around the NBA, but I've always found that the best rebounders usually aren't the biggest guy. They're the most tenacious, and they have excellent timing and the ability to get off their feet multiple times quicker than their opponent.
And the basket by Scola.
The defense has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
Boy, I'd like to know how many of their attempts have come from inside 5 feet. It seems like everything is right at the rim.
Here's G. 9 points in the game so far. The turnaround J misses off the left iron. Pacers trail by 13. And George, here we go. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. It's back to Hill. In low to Scola. And he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
Tell you what, he's not going to win any high jump competition, so it's a good thing he doesn't have to go too far to get to the rim.
I'm not sure he of us could slip a piece of paper under him when he takes off.
Well, it doesn't matter much so, Kevin, because he's such a big man. I mean, if he gets position, forget about it.
And here is Los Angeles now, following the score by Indiana. Stuckey into the lane. There's the pass to George. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits. Los Angeles leading by 11. Here's G. Feeds it to Kobe. Paul George with the steal. Here's Hill. Chandler with the block. And that'll be Indiana as it goes out of bounds. Pacers retain possession.
Over the last 10 games, Kevin, you can see where the Lakers rank in the league right now. First in shooting percentage. First in three-point field goal percentage. And they're also ranked number one in taking care of the ball. Not many turnovers. They value possessions like no other.
And the shooting is really what stands out to me. This is a team that does such a good job of finding open looks. They're unselfish. They work offensively to create good shots. And when they do that, they're on their game. They're tough to beat.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass. Go get those boards.
Any extra possessions that you can get, either through steals or rebounds, are so critical in this game.
Here's G. 9 points in the game so far. They set the pick. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. That three off the mark.
He just couldn't shake loose. He had the defender draped all over him.
Stuckey into the lane. Off the mark. Had a chance to trim it to single digits. 4-on-3 as they bring it up. Pass to Hill. Dishes it to G to stop the drought. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. And 12 points for G. Oh, with that last huddle, you could see the coach was addressing how they were going to make a tactical adjustment.
And after the coach does something like that, it's on the players now to lock in and follow the lead and execute. If they don't, then the coach will put them on the pine.
Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. And it's Bryant in the corner. Can't get it to go. So Indiana will take it the other way. This, their first look at this year's Los Angeles squad.
Well, last year they won both meetings in the season series, and it wasn't a surprise. I mean, this is the better team.
Here's G. 12 points for him. Fast break. Here comes Indiana. Cut it, and the Laker lead has been cut down now to just 10 points with that basket from Stuckey. Los Angeles has gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break.
You know, Clark, it can be a point of pride. Hey, you know, we split 1-1 with the marquee team from the other conference. But, you know,
it's something to point to, Kevin. You know, when your overall season is a disappointment, that's something that you can look at and say, hey, progress.
4 on the shot clock. Crandall with the bucket.
Ran his man straight into that screen to open the lane up for the hoop.
Pacers trail by 12. Ted Davis has checked in for Los Angeles. Gerald Green comes in for Bryant. Indiana also making some changes. Novak's checked in, and it's C.J. Miles in for Rodney Stuckey. Doris Burke has some information for us, Doris.
Kevin, Doc Rivers was just addressing the plan with his team. He made it clear that their offense needed to run through G. The coach is calling on him to play a big role in the offense for the rest of this game, to really be one of the key guys for them down the stretch. He mentioned one more thing, which was that he'd like them to get out and run whenever they get their hands on the ball. Let's play this game at top speed. Those were his exact words. Those could prove to be crucial changes to their strategy with this game getting ready to enter the stretch drive, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thanks. Here's Clark after the basket by Los Angeles. George double-teamed. He kicks it to Mahimi. Back to George. Six to shoot. We have a step back, and the Pacers tack on two more.
Well, he's been a real positive factor for them today, although, you know, as a team, they've had a lot of negatives mixed in there as well.
G kicks to Hill, passes it to G, and low to Davis. And that one's good. Davis has got 10 points in the game.
Nice, accurate pass right into the middle.
Pacers trail by 12. Outside, George. Out to the wing. It's Novak from outside. The shot's good on the assist by George. George has got 3 assists now in this one.
I like the offensive awareness to exploit that lack of coverage on that play.
Here's G. He's got 12. And here's Green outside. Paul George grabs the miss. George has got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Miles dishes to Clark. And Miles kicks to Mahimi. Indiana moving it around. Pass to Novak. Out of bounds. The Lakers will take possession.
Such a careless pass.
Nice shooting.
Checked in for Hill.
Wake up, son. You're in.
Oh, it's time to ball.
So it's the Pacers now. Down by 12. Their next game is at Oracle Arena, so a road game with the Warriors. And that's the final game of this 5-game road run for the team.
No doubt the Golden State fans, some of the best in the league, they want to see their Warriors win that one.
Now here's Hibbert. 10 points for him. No good off the front iron. Five seconds left to play in the third. That will count. That misses. Would have counted had it gone in. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game.
Coming up next Monday, January 18th, Kobe Bryant and the Los Angeles Lakers go up against the Sacramento Kings. It's a Pacific Division showdown. You don't want to miss it.
And how about a look now at our assist of the game? Barnes.
This was a showstopper, wasn't it? Just a difficult pass to make, and he makes it flawlessly to set up that alley-oop.
G, he's in at the point. Wilson Chandler out there with Caron Butler. Then it's Jeremy Lin, and it's Randall in at the center. That's the Laker 5. Here's G. Roy Hibbert picking up that last basket. There's the pick. G passes to Randall. A 3 ball. And he hits it from deep. 3 points there from G. And the Lakers lead by 13.
Man, they are spreading the floor and letting it fly. Really knocking it down from outside.
And I love that gunslinger's mentality, Steve. Playing to win as opposed to playing it safe. I call it prevent offense when you try to protect the lead. Let it fly, let it fly, let it fly.
Now here's Lynn. Paul George unable to get his shot to go. 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. They get the rebound. Another shot. Randle with the bucket.
He's enjoying himself today, guys. We knew going in that he had have the upper hand on the glass, but I didn't think it would make this much of a difference.
Outside Hill. And he makes good on the layup.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Los Angeles leading by 13. G dishes to Randle. The 11-footer, and he gets it to go. 17 points for G.
His shooting's been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons his team is up in this game.
The drive by Hill, and he gets the bucket.
Well, nothing was going down for him in the first half, but since the break, he's been on target.
L.A. has gone 5-9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. Lynn kicks to Randle and stolen by Hibbert. Stuckey outside. Hill passes to Hibbert. Hill drives in and he gets it to go. Hill's got six here in this quarter. Lakers have gone 3-4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Gee to the middle. Knocks it loose and stolen by Hibbert. And now the fast break. Hill with the ball. He feeds it to George. Scola, a screen on Chandler. Hill has the open look. A three-pointer off the mark.
Very little success for him behind the arc today. Just one three-pointer in the first half and still none in the second.
And Randle throws it down.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
No, Clark, that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
Yeah, what a beautiful connection on that play.
Here's Hibbert, following the basket by Julius Randle. And here's Hill for three. The shot's good on the assist by George. George has got four assists now tonight.
And now both of these clubs really in a groove here.
Already a high-scoring game, but it has become an offensive showcase down the stretch.
And he gets it to go.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. The drive by Hill. Here's Scola. Battles through traffic and lays it in.
And things are going to come way too easy for him if he can get that deep post position.
I agree with you, Steve. You've got to deny him the ball down there as best you can.
Now here's Lynn. Kicks it to G for the three. That's good. G's got a couple of three-pointers now in the fourth for the Lakers.
Might as well just take it into his own hands and make that big lead even bigger.
Hill kicks to Scola. And the Lakers have possession. Los Angeles leading by 13. Here's Lynn. Takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
I just love the mentality they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing anything. They're moving it side to side and working to get a good shot.
And George here.
Wow. What a throwdown. Yes. Look at that athletic play. Incredible.
Wow. Even when they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular. And he pulled it off.
Well, maybe, yeah, maybe this is the best time to do it.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, now's when they need a little spark anyway.
The Lakers with the ball. The Pacers making the shot. Here's G. Down to five on the shot clock. That one rolling around and rims out. Pacers trail by 13. Deflects the pass. Lynn with the steal. And it's the Lakers on the break. Here's G. Count that one. G's got 15 points in just the second half. And now we'll get a perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for the Lakers.
Boy, defensively, they've played with a high energy. All the steals we've seen. Really a result of that aggressiveness.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Hill, he's checked in for Butler. That's Bryant in for Jeremy Lin. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
I was able to listen in on what Frank Vogel had to say to his team. He's not pleased with the careless turnovers offensively, saying, listen, we've got to get shots. It's as simple as that. We have to play smart and value the basketball. Kevin, did it sink in?
Now, here is Hill, following the miss by Luis Scola. And there's the three-second call, this one on the defense. And the technical free throw is good. And George kicks to Hill. Misses the three.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, he had a really good look. I mean, he'll knock that down more often than not.
Here's G. Got a piece of it. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession.
That was an awfully risky pass, guys. He's lucky it didn't wind up as a steal.
Well, it nearly did wind up as a steal, but no harm done in the end. They hang on to possession.
Poke loose. And there's the bucket. Stayed with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. And that's now 6 points for Hill. Pacers trail by 16. Hill kicks to Stucker. Some nice passing here by Indiana. It's George on the wing. He's guarded by Chandler. The feed to Hill. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Hill's got 13 points in the second half.
The points just keep coming for him this quarter. And just at the right time, too, as they try to narrow the deficit.
And blocked. Now here's Hill, the fast break opportunity. That one's good. The Laker lead is cut down now to just 12 points with the basket from Stuckey.
I'd say that fast break went according to plan.
Yeah, it sure did. A good job getting it started and a better job finishing it off.
Here's G. Up off the screen.
What a throwdown there. Man.
And he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is safe.
Well, if not 100% safe, certainly 95%.
And so only one team answered the bell tonight. Not a monster blowout by any means, but still a double-digit victory for Los Angeles.
You know, it's tough to put your finger on the deciding factor in this one, but I'd say that the shooting accuracy made the difference.
Shot quality and better overall shooting.
And when it's all said and done here, this will mark their 38th W on the year.
Well, one thing about this win, it assures that they will not lose the season series. They only meet once more, of course, as interconference opponents.
And Steve, when it is just a two-game season series, the team winning game one has a bit of an edge going into the second meeting, knowing they've already solved their opponent one time and only have to do it once more.
Fantastic show put on. What an amazing game all around it was for G. He just looked like an orchestrator out there, keeping his teammates involved, running to the open spots. I mean, he would constantly find them more often than not. Terrific job taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And, Steve, I thought those fans, those home fans, gave this team a big lift all game. A lot of positive energy in the building.
A nice shot by George.
Looks like they're going to finish strong, but just aren't enough ticks left on the clock.
Well, Steve, it's a good run they're having now, but they just waited too long to have it.
Takes a three. Misses. So it's Los Angeles winning.
Hi, Kevin. Well, Kobe, tell us about how this team has progressed from a chemistry standpoint.
Well, we're right where we need to be, you know, in terms of, you know, figuring out the rhythm that we need to play with and, you know, playing for each other. And, you know, like we're at right now.
Kobe, thank you. Playing for each other.
Last game, we really struggled getting production out of the pick and roll. So we're going to work it today. Same as always, a solid screen
and an aggressive roll to the basket, we run the pick and roll correctly, there's no way anybody can stop it. Now let's go.
I'm hurting, that you ain't too young, like I'm Kyrie Kirkland. I'm on the block with consistency. something that I just can't tell.
Hey, that was one of the worst efforts I've seen out of you. You were a step slow all practice, and you weren't doing the things we talked about. Now listen, it's not the end of the world. Everybody has an off day. If this continues, though, your role on this team might change. So put it behind you and be better tomorrow, all right? All right?
All right.